Hello everyone, welcome to the first session of Learn Ionic series. Today we will have a quick introduction of Ionic and also have the simple demonstration of Hello World app. So let us quickly go through the agenda. As the Ionic 5 is all about the main goal of Ionic 5 is cross-platform. So first we will discuss what are the cross-platform apps and how it's work, what is Ionic, why Ionic, and the simple demonstration of Hello World app. Okay, so what are cross-platform apps? Cross-platform apps are popular because they allow developers to write on code once and accommodate multiple platforms, that is Android, iOS, and Windows. The core of the application is written using HTML5, CSS, and JavaScript, and it also provides the full access to the mobile device features using native plugins. And it also helps in bring your own device trend in the business world. In the today's scenario, rarely the mobile app only designed for the single platform. Means the consumer partners and employees are all have a choice of platform and devices. As we already discussed, write code once and run everywhere. So it will look this. So let us discuss how cross-platform app works. Cross-platform apps run in with embedded browser, but it is invisible to the user. That is, iOS app will use the WK web view to display the application, and Android will use the web view element, and it feels like a native app to the user. Then the code is embedded into the native application wrapper using Apache Cordova or Capacitor. They will create the native shell application, that is just the platform web view component, and that will load our web application. So what is Ionic? Ionic is open source SDK for building the performant and high quality mobile and desktop application. It is built on the top of AngularJS and Apache Cordova. And it uses the HTML, CSS and JavaScript and convert them into native code to make the application available for multiple platforms. Ionic framework mainly focuses on front-end UX and UI interaction of an application, and it's very easy to learn and can integrate with the libraries or frameworks such as Angular, React or Vue. By choosing Ionic framework based on open web standard technology, we will future-proof our development strategies in important ways. For example, latest version of Ionic work with any JS framework includes React, Vue, and Angular, so team can continue to use diverse set of tools and approaches. Okay. So why one should use Ionic as a framework for mobile app development? So these are the features that Ionic framework mainly provide: free and open source. Ionic framework is 100% free and open source project, licensed under MIT and powered by massive worldwide community. It's fully cross-platform, as we already discussed. Build PWA and native mobile application for every major app store with one code base. Ionic works and looks beautiful wherever it runs. UI with RTL support. RTL stands for right to left. CSS and JavaScript gives us the higher customization option and options for button, menu, etc. And we have right to left language support for publishing the apps in multiple languages such as Arabic, Urdu, etc. Then we have a clean, simple and functional design. Built with real application example, component guides and how to get up and running mobile application faster. start at a scale with 100 plus ready to use customized component. Then we have a native Cordova plugin. Ionic use over 120 plus native device features like Bluetooth, Health Kit, fingerprint authentication, and more with Cordova or Capacitor plugin with a TypeScript extension. And also we have a first-class documentation. Starting from Ionic 3, which is built on the top of Angular 4, has improved everything the developers have ever wanted in hybrid technology because of immense mobile component typography and interactive paradigm. Developers find the Ionic very enjoyable to use. Let us quickly go through the simple demonstration of the Ionic app. As per the official document of the Ionic, to get started with the Ionic framework, the only requirement is a Node and NPM environment. So we can go through the link and we will make sure to install the LTS version of Node and also NPM. And the code editor is recommended is Visual Studio Code. Okay. After installing, we will make sure the version of NPM and Node using this command. Then we need to install the Ionic CLI. As mentioned in the document. Then we can create the Ionic application using this command. Ionic start hello world, name of the application, and the layout, it can be blank, side menu, tabs, etc. And the type we need to mention is Angular. It can be a React or Vue as well. So let us quickly start the. Well, the create of an application may take some time, so I already created an application and just go through the name. Let us open the Hello World application in the Visual Code. Yes. After installing the application, we need to build the app using Ionic build command. Okay, so it's built. Now we need to run the Ionic Capacitor at Android command so that the Android project will be created at the root of the project. So it's already added in my directory. So first let me remove it. Then we'll create the command. Every time we build the app that updates the www directory, we will need to copy these changes into our native projects. So next we will need to run the Ionic cap copy command. to copy our updated changes into the native project directory. And after copying, we need to sync the update to the native portion of the code. For that, we need to run the ionic cap sync, where cap is stand for capacitor. Okay, so now we can run the Ionic application on our web browser emulator on or our hardware devices. So first let's run on the web browser. For that we can use Ionic serve command. Hello world explorer. As we have used the tab, so the tab is displayed. We can also run the app on emulator. For that we need to make sure the installation of Android Studio in our machine as per the official document for Android development. We need to run the application on emulator using Capacitor or Cordova. Means either we can use Capacitor or Cordova. So first let us discuss what Capacitor and Cordova is. Capacitor is an open source cross-platform app runtime that allows the web application to run natively on Android, iOS, Windows, etc. And Cordova is also an open source mobile application development framework that transforms the standard web technology into the full-fledged native application. It provides a JS API for accessing the native device functionality. So the main difference between them is Capacitor is similar to Cordova, but also supports creating the progressive web app application that can use same functionality in browser, but as a native apps. Okay. So we need to make sure the installation of Android Studio in our machine, and we can install Android SDK. And after installing the Android Studio, we also need to create the Android virtual device, which we can use as a emulator. Okay. And for syncing of the application with the Android Studio, we need to add some configuration in the application. Here it is, capacitor.config.json file, and we need to add this property Linux Android Studio path, and here we will add the path where the Android Studio is installed. Okay. Now we need to run this command ionic capacitor open Android, or we can also use ionic capacitor run Android hyphen L, where L stand for live reload. Okay, so we can also use this command for running the application in emulator. Okay, so let's try. Now we need to run the app. I already prepared the Android virtual devices. As per the official document, you can also create the virtual devices by referring this document. The steps are given to them. Okay, so now we can run the app on emulator. Okay, so here is the application run on the emulator. We have the tab layout and that's all.
Thank you, Humaira, and all the participants.